I think it's about the same as what it was last week.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's like alternates every.
All right, I'm here at Starbucks working, and now we're about to have a meeting. I've been by myself, and look at this meal that I just got delivered by my such a great husband.
Have you brought it out?
Look at this beautiful meal. What kind of meat is this?
Nice full beer.
Chicken, veggies, avocado, rice,
so like if I let it go
and julienne sauce.
Heck yeah.
It's almost 5 o'clock on Saturday, and I got home about an hour ago. Walked in to Knox kind of already crying with Lucy, Julian's mom. And when I walked in, he started crying more. And when I would get close to him, he would scream. But if I told him I was going to leave him alone, he would scream. And then Julian came in and he started crying even harder. Anyways, full toddler, like 30 minutes of screaming, crying, meltdown. Followed by needing 30 minutes of snuggle, calm down, I'm okay. And now it's time to work out. I'm gonna make up yesterday's street parking workout. I would love to just take a bath, to be honest, but just gonna bust this out really quick. There's no, it has bent over rows in it because I can't do pull-ups, but other than that, it's not like weighted or anything. It's got box jumps. We'll see how I feel. It's a pretty fast one, probably like 10 minutes. So gonna go get after it.
All right, so this workout's pretty simple. It's just 2 rounds of 20 pull-ups, 20 box jumps, 20 bent over rows, 20 box jumps. So I'm gonna do a supine row for the pull-ups and then dumbbell bent over rows. I have committed to a lower box for the rest of the pregnancy. So this is probably gonna go pretty fast, which is just fine. Box jumps in today's workout, I had 5 left and I got like a little cramp on my right side. And then when I was walking Chongo, I got the same cramp on my right side. And I was really far away from home and it did not feel good. I had to walk, whoa, shoot. I had to walk all the way home with it. So I'm laying on the couch. I ate my dinner here and it's gone away now, but I'm gonna try box jumps maybe one more time. I'm not sure if that did it or the massive amounts of hang squat cleans I did last night combined with the box jumps today, or if I'm just having a weird crampy day, but ouch. It's like almost 9 o'clock, I think. Gonna go upstairs and try to get some better sleep tonight. I mean, I'm just gonna be woken up by Knox at 10:45 anyway, but tomorrow's a rest day and I'm looking forward to it. All right, so I've been getting a lot of questions on my Instagram and on YouTube, mostly on Instagram lately, about what I'm eating at this stage, because in all my posts I say I eat the way that I've always eaten. I did do a 45-minute vlog a few months before I got pregnant of an entire day of eating, which is pretty much still the same way that I eat, other than the fact that I have poke, which is raw fish, in that day. Everything else is basically the same. But I'm gonna do it again on this week's pregnancy vlog because I get so many questions about it. So here we go. A lot of stuff left over from yesterday's breakfast, because we always make a bunch. So I didn't need to cook anything fresh. But basically I'm gonna have oatmeal
egg whites, a bunch of fruit, and almond butter. I put it all in one bowl, and I kind of eat the egg whites first still anyway. But a lot of people, a lot of the street parking members do the same breakfast and they'll like mix it up, which is also can be tasty. The only difference with being pregnant is that I eat one piece of bacon every morning. So that's it. I don't like, this is really hard to do with one hand. I don't like measure or weigh my food when I'm pregnant. And I wasn't really weighing and measuring my food before either, to be honest, because I've just eaten the same thing for so long. Come on. But yeah, like a good amount of oats, and then I'll throw some of this fruit on there, like a handful of each one. Actually, I'm gonna heat these up first. Hold on. All right, so that's about the amount of egg whites that I have. Blueberries. Blackberries. Raspberries. I'm gonna throw some banana on there. And there it is. And I will eat that for breakfast literally every day of my life, unless we go out for breakfast on a special occasion. It's delicious, I love it. It's simple, and I don't have to think about it.
All right, next part of my daily meals. I already ate it, almost forgot to film it. A chocolate chip perfect bar. Sometimes it's a pumpkin perfect bar, almost always chocolate chip. Not something I would necessarily eat if I was actively trying to lose weight, because it's a lot of calories and it's just a small bar. It's 320 calories, but pretty much since I got pregnant with Knox almost 3 years, or yeah, over 3 years ago, I've eaten one of these every single day. I'm in a hurry a lot of times, and packing tons of meals doesn't always work when I'm on the go. So those have worked really well for me, and it's a good way for me to get in some calories and to feed this growing baby when I'm in a rush. All right, it's workout time. We're doing the second workout in the Street Parking Vault series. It's 40 minutes long, if you last that long. Has pull-ups in it. I'm modifying to the supine rows. I'm gonna do push-ups from my knees as long as it feels fine on my belly. Air squats are fine. I'm modifying the run to a bike, which is allowed anyway. And that's it. But yeah, 40 minutes is a really long time. But I'm not alone today. I've got the whole crew. So, there we go. I forgot to show you my post-workout shake, which was like, honestly, 2.5 hours ago. I've shown this on several vlogs, but in case somehow you didn't see it. Post-workout I did, today was a long workout, so I did 2 scoops of this. Sometimes I'll only do one. This is Progenics Build. It's like a carb supplement. It's sweet potatoes and honey, basically. This is Bubs collagen protein. Collagen, you might have heard, is like good for like hair and nails and everything like that. It's also super safe during pregnancy, and I mean, that baby needs a lot of collagen too, so maybe he's able to use it. And then I used Progenics More Muscle and the Build actually in both pregnancies. I usually just do 1 scoop. Cookies and cream is my favorite.
So that's what I had about 2.5 hours ago after my workout.
Now, my timing for eating today is off because normally I work out later. So normally I would have had this next meal before my post-workout meal. And I would have had this one before and then the post-workout meal and then another one like this after. But it's like 5 o'clock and I'm eating lunch technically, which is out of order, but you still will get the idea.
So this is rice underneath there, which you can't really see, ground turkey, like 200 grams of veggies. That's weighed out grams, by the way, and avocado. And sometimes while I've been pregnant, I'll crumple up some tortilla chips and put it on top just because. This will be probably exactly what my dinner is as well after Knox is asleep. Did have a little bit of this hummus and chips while I was waiting for this food, just to be honest.
Final meal, it's pretty much exactly the same as the last meal. Rice, ground turkey, veggies, avocado, and that's it. It's about 2 hours later than I normally eat this, but that's because my day is messed up. 9 o'clock at night, I'm gonna eat this and go to bed. All right, it's Tuesday morning. Normally I was planning on squatting on Mondays and Wednesdays. But we had like a really long high volume workout yesterday, so I skipped it. And I'm getting in my squats right now. I already did the first set and warmed up and everything, so this is just the second set. It's still Wednesday, January 15th. I'm just here on my couch, about to answer some emails, honestly, while watching The Bachelor. Get caught up a little bit. It's like almost 9 o'clock. Earlier today, our staff went and got their body fat tested. We did it last year in March. And then they did it in September, but I was already pregnant. And then they went and did it again. And it's just like one of those like things that like set me off today to feel kind of left out of the group. Julian had lost, I want to say 3.5 or 4% body fat since September. Which just solidifies how something in his mind is triggered when I'm pregnant to really focus on his diet and his training, because last time I was pregnant is when he was the most fit he had ever been and qualified for the CrossFit Games, and it was like this huge deal. And now I mean, obviously we have a fitness community of 20,000 people that he will tell about this accomplishment. And it's just hard because, you know, I remember still like so clearly this time when I was pregnant with Knox, when we were at Chipotle, we were like in line at Chipotle, and the worker there was talking about how fit he was and how amazing he looked. And then they literally asked me if I even, like, they said, so do you like to work out too? And it was so frustrating to me and made me angry, because inside I just wanted to scream, like, I've been doing this longer than he has. I'm the one that's teaching him how to eat. And yeah, so I kind of had like a resurgence of that today. And the feeling at regionals where last time where, and today where I'm so proud of him and I want this for him, and it's not like he's taking anything from me with these accomplishments for himself, but it's just
my life in those areas once again is on pause while he's excelling so much, and there will be such a hype around it, and the crew's doing all this stuff together. There's all these bro sesh training sessions and endurance sessions, and they're going to get their body fat tested, and he's playing around with his diet and trying this thing and that thing, and I'm just over here frumping away, you know, in the corner by myself. I'm just really glad that I had been injured pretty badly several times before getting pregnant, because I've been in that situation at least a few times where I've been the person over in the corner kind of just watching life go by and doing the best that I can, and I learned a lot from that, but it's really hard. And it's really hard to feel alone in it, and we had a talk about it tonight because I didn't want any sort of like resentment to build up, and I could feel some jealousy and frustration about it building up. So we talked about it, and I basically told him again, like, this is just one of those times where I need to hear thank you from you, because if the roles were switched and somehow you could be the pregnant one this time, you wouldn't be able to be over here losing 4% body fat. You wouldn't be able to be over here being the highlight of the street parking vault workouts and doing all these fun extra workouts with our staff and playing around with your diet. And you could still be learning about nutrition, but you couldn't be applying as much of it right now. And I just, you know, wanted him to remember that this journey that I'm going through isn't mine alone. It's for both of us. And just as Knox is just as much his son as he is mine, so will baby be. And I just wanted to hear thank you again. And just, you know, he asked me, what do you want to get away? What do you want me to take away from this conversation? Because I want to make sure I understand. And basically I said, and I think this is advice to any spouse or significant other, you don't understand. I don't want you to think you understand. I actually am to the point now where I don't want him to think that he understands. I want him to know that he doesn't, and that he won't ever, and that it's harder than he can, like, understand, I guess. And to just know that, and to know that whatever he thinks it might be like in his mind, that it's harder than that, and that he doesn't get it, and that's okay. But just to remember that it's real, and it is really hard, and that it's not that I don't feel supported, because he supports me so much. It's more that I want to hear thank you. So that's it. It was a hard day today. It's mostly my own issues, but it comes out through seeing that stuff going on with him and our crew.
All right, it's Thursday, January, I don't know, 16th. Just got to the office here. It's 12:30. I'm popping over here because, look at my lipstick. What's going on here? Because Jeb, who is one of our street parking maintenance, that's kind of like our yoga mobility thing that we have from street parking members, is doing like kind of a yoga class for our staff today. And I'm sore and my hips are really tight, and I'm probably gonna have to modify some stuff, but I'm super pumped for it, especially cause it's my rest day anyway. This is perfect. So feeling good, got some good sleep last night, and just, yeah, ready to go do some maintenance. We'll be right back.
like 10 o'clock at night on Thursday. Julian and I went to dinner earlier, like 6 hours ago at 4:30. And I got like something that I normally get at this place. It's like a chicken breast like club sandwich. And I have not really bad, but kind of uncomfortable heartburn. I haven't really dealt with heartburn in this pregnancy, but I had it really bad in my last pregnancy. And I honestly think at least part of it has to do with the fact that we ate out a lot more when I was pregnant with Knox than we do now. Because it seems like it pops up way more often when I eat out than when I eat our meals from home. So just a little heads up, if that's something that you're dealing with, is maybe to look into how often you're eating out. It sucks. I'm not joking, this baby in my belly moves more than I do. I don't know what he's doing in there, but today's been the most movement by far of any day so far. It's been constant, like even just talking to you right now. He's just like, I don't know, like dancing on, like it's like at the very bottom too, and I love it, but it's also kind of uncomfortable at times. He's really going for it. It's been maybe windows of like 5 or 10 minutes here and there where he's not, but the rest of the day today, I don't know what the deal is. He's going wild.